Stanislas Damiba was only 12 years old when he was sent to Cuba by the father of Burkina Faso's revolution, Thomas Sankara. He was one of 600 young people from poor backgrounds, most of them orphans, who were to study on Fidel Castro's island to learn to build their country.
Thomas Sankara was a father and remains a father, as we call him today, our spiritual father. And he said this, study well to come and develop your country. And he also said that you must have a revolutionary belly. This meant that whatever the host country served, you had to eat, because the revolutionary adapts at any time and in any place. And right after that, he was killed.
Et juste après, il a été assassiné.
Thomas Sankara's assassination and his successor Blaise Campaore's rise to power shattered the dreams of those known as Thomas Sankara's orphans. The new regime forbade them from studying and cut off funding.
Everything we should have had as a scholarship, as training, was flatly wiped out. This revolutionary ideal was simply killed in its infancy, and us with it.
Most of the orphans have returned to Burkina Faso. Their education is, however, not recognized in their home country. Many failed to get jobs in the public service sector, as was promised to them. Damibi found work in the private sector and is now a civil engineering technician. He runs an association to fight for compensation, especially for his less fortunate peers.
Today we mourn 85 of our comrades who have died, some by suicide, 245 who are in the civil service and underemployed, and 460 who are effectively unemployed.
The Burkinabe Reconciliation Body is currently hearing a case that could lead to official recognition of the failed experiment. While the orphans of the revolution hope for reparations, a trial has started at last of those accused of their spiritual father's killing 34 years later.